class we have for now. We'll work up to it.
Bravo.
What did you think?
It's early in the morning. So, I'm glad I heard a little bit of the second one because it's always easier when you play louder to have more presence in the sound, sort of digging the string. But, and it gets harder as you play softer to still have content in the sound. And so, I did think that at the beginning you could have more gradations in your dynamics, piano, pianissimo. And so you could play softer at times, but I still need a little bit more presence in the sound. Because this kind of sound, sometimes in this music it can work, but the very beginning, for example, is piano only, right? It's not pianissimo. And to me, it felt just, the sound felt sort of without substance, if you know what I mean, right? So when you play loud, beautiful bow technique, everything works beautifully, but when you play soft, sunrise, right, in French. So let's see if we can have a little bit more of that. And I know you weren't warmed up or anything, but a little more magic maybe in this end possible. Sometimes a lot of them do that is you lock your knees. And I really feel that we violinists shouldn't be doing that. It's like the other day I had this image, it's like a cello. You know how cellists are always obsessed with their end pins and the material, and it's the thing that's grounded to the floor. And our legs are, I mean, totally a part of violin. So if everything is locked here, is rigid, it doesn't, it's okay, but it won't help you as much. So, out of curiosity, can you actually, you know the beginning by heart, right? Can you just sort of walk and play the beginning casually? The sound, the spin, everything starts working better just because everything is in flow in your body. It's not rigid for the stand. So you have to remember this. And often when I practice, I'll walk a little bit. So one more time, you can stand still. And remember, breathe in, breathe out, yeah? So many markers, and Ysaye was one of the greatest violinists of his time, and incredible composer, and almost every note has a little indication. You really need to know what he asked for, right? Otherwise, there's a big box SB, that's not really what it is. No, it's important, and I don't know if you have the legend, but yes, you do, look, right here. Beginning of the book. So again, the same thing for me. Every time I see pianissimo on a page, piano and then pianissimo, I tell myself, if I play the piano too soft, pianissimo, I just won't have any room to play, right? So the first one, it's not that you should play loud, but it should be more open. So you give yourself, can you just play these two measures once? Just play this, and then play this. Play the first and third measure. So this measure, so we hear the difference between piano and pianissimo. Do we hear a difference? Not too much, right? So, really pianissimo the second one, a little louder the first one. Is that okay? Okay. Good. I would suggest maybe doing the dynamics by lightening up the pressure, which is a good way to do it, but you're using the same amount of bow. And I wonder if you could do it by actually using a little less bow. So the first one, maybe the second one. The soft, not have the core. And I'm not one of those people that is completely obsessed with core, because I realize that there are many tones you can get. And playing with my teacher, Mr. Perlman, core all the time. And you hear it in his playing, and it's gorgeous, and I agree with that concept for, you know, 90% of cases. But there is some music, like, you know, even this music. So maybe here, I'm on the verge of saying maybe it's okay if you don't entirely have core. But I do think, just for the sake of the lesson today or the masterclass, that we could work a little bit on your soft sound. But, you know, there's music like WC Sonata. You don't really need the core too much. Maybe a little here. But still, it's very important to know how to play a soft sound and have that presence and that content that carries through the hall. Okay? So, can we work a little bit more on this here? And you know what it is? I think, to me, you're a little bit too much in suspense here. So, they're both flow. So, you, and as I said, your technique, your forearm looks very good, but can you really feel that you're using gravity? And even though it's soft, you're just letting your bow fall on the string and relax down, like use the gravity to get your sound. There you go. That's it. Good? Second one. Much better to me. Okay, can you do both parts now? For example, I heard between the that's the sound I heard in between the notes. Did you mean that? You did. Okay, good. How about this one? Sometimes I'm not entirely sure because it sounds a little flautando, a little ponticello. shoulder should be low. The elbow, your elbow is fine, right? It should be a straight line. I'm sure your teacher totally vouches for this, which is, you know, and this is a very Russian, or at least this is my Russian teacher, the way he was teaching this is, you want this whole surface, the square right here, to be a plain surface, right? And so this needs to be low at all times. You never want to do this. And but your elbow needs to go along with the height of the whatever string you're playing on. So you're on the G string, your elbow is going to be here. You're on the E string, your elbow is going to be here. But it's a straight line. You never want to break this, right? If you break the system, it doesn't work. So when I'm asking for gravity, using gravity and downward force, shoulder stays low, but the elbow doesn't, right? So and by no means do I mean also to go with high elbow. I don't mean that either. But you just want to use gravity for yourself. Right? More character because it's so difficult. Our instruments are so difficult. But that's why I made you walk earlier and beat your foot so you feel the rhythm and let yourself be free a little bit. I don't really hear the character of the rustic dance and whatnot. So that's why I want you to just start having fun and right? Pretend like you're a rock musician or something. Yeah? You can play the violin. Let's go. There you go. Oh, the bad actor. playing?
Barber first.
Barber, okay, great. And then?
Bach.
Bach, okay. Play something? Which one?